No Jumper, coolest podcast in the world, and today we have Cyril. Cyril, you say it for me.
Cyril.
This is a whole controversy we're having here.
Cyril.
Cyril.
Yeah.
Roy.
People
Walker.
Say my name wrong so much.
I call him Cyril, but it's Cyril.
He don't matter. He don't.
Yeah. I don't matter at all.
Roast him at some point during the interview. Yeah,
please roast me. Please. Then, I need to be roasted.
To my left, we have Hesh, and we got a little house phone who are sharing a mic, just like they share women and blunts. And
Wow, just on blood. Wow. That's how y'all get down?
That's how we rock 2016.
Like they're real foul.
I guess.
Dirty ass guys, I got to tell you. And then you want to introduce your homeboy over here?
Oh, this is Joe Mayo.
This is my son. Joe X Mayo, that man.
So this is like...
You jack off a lot? Is that why?
Talking to the mic. When you're going to ask him about masturbating, you got to talk into the mic.
I don't know. Mayo could be like a simile for cum.
Right.
I don't know.
Rope.
Whoa. Could it? Simile?
Comment with like, is it like Patty Mayo or like your last name? That's really his last name.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's why.
Comment
I was
with
like,
the definition of simile because what you just said is not it. Hey, you know, I had a good idea though. I was watching this like poker video, and like when they get into a big hand, they start talking about something serious. They just like.
I can turn into Lil Fitch.
So if I ask you something that I'm like nervous about, I'm just gonna put the glasses on. That could be like the code for like, yo, I'm not comfortable with this.
You just like transform real fast.
Yeah, this is my idea.
I feel that. That's fire.
All right. So this is like a guest. Well, not a guest, but like. Hesh recommended this podcast. He was like, you got to do this one.
Yeah,
so even though you're hating on him, you're roasting him left and right.
Man.
So tell us about him that made you feel like you needed to be on the pod.
If you guys don't know, these two men are the reason why you niggas are zooming in and out of your videos. You feel me? These two created that. So skate videos, bike videos, even just on Snapchat, just slaying your homies, just zooming in and out. Like, they started that real shit. So, yeah.
Does that ring true? You feel like you're an influential Instagram editor?
Kinda. I feel like people are more tuned into the music and the tricks that we're doing.
Yeah, right.
It's the combination
tricks.
Of everything.
Oh, yeah.
You in particular.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. On top of the style and whatnot. It's just like all the way around. That's what just like people in general, but like skaters know like these two niggas are like real on the board.
Hey, that's facts.
So
but yeah. Let's talk about the Instagram editing, because I found that real interesting. Like, when did you start to actually like put effort into how you presented your Instagram videos? Because everybody, when Instagram first started doing video, it was just the most standard, standing there, not no zooming or nothing, because it wasn't really on the iPhone at the time. How do you like decide, like, was it just a slow maturation into this?
It was kind of like a slow maturation into it. It was more of like I started to notice people were like really tuning in, so I'm just like, fuck man, I'm about to really try to flip it on these people and like make my own style of editing pretty much.
Right.
And he helped me because he had his like own little style. Like everything he did was like the whole video was slow motion.
Right.
And you'd like slow down the songs and all that too.
We started posting those on Instagram.
You put that right in your mouth.
Oh yeah. Sorry. We started posting those on Instagram.
Put that in your mouth.
That's always a problematic statement.
Problematic.
No, say that. It's like
those on Instagram, and then like those started getting like. He was in the spotlight because he was better than me and everything, and then I would usually be filming it. So
yeah. I would honestly, like, I've been following, like, both of them, you feel me? Like, back when I used to live in Riverside, my boy, this is how I found out about Cyril, my boys would be like, yo, like, Cyril just posted a video of me. I was just like, man, who the fuck is this nigga? It's Cyril. It's Cyril, honestly, my boy Nighthawk, that's what he calls him. And... from then on, like him, fucking shouts out to Joe McGurvey, because that nigga too, that ugly ass nigga Roderick, that's my little nigga. All them niggas, but their tricks is like dumb crazy, and it's like seeing this nigga skate Darby or like Stoner is like real crazy if you ever got to experience it. So another thing. Your boy Sebo. Talk about him.
Sebo.
Talk about Sebo.
Sebo is the man.
Yeah.
Sebo's the man for sure.
Shouts out Sebo, man. That nigga's dumb good. Like, dumb good. Yeah, amazing. So tell us about your relationship with Sebo. And tell us who Sebo is.
Pretty much.
What his last name, because I don't know if anybody.
Sebo Walker?
Yeah, there you go. That man.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, he's the man at Stoner. Like, he got on Lakai. Everybody started learning Lakais. And, like, he was just doing his thing and got on Crooked and all that other stuff. So he's the man. Like, everybody looks up to him.
Yeah, who got you into skateboarding? Or like, what was the process like where you got involved?
I started skating when I was like 10 years old. And I've been skating on and off my whole life. But like throughout high school, like, I kind of stopped and like got into like doing dumb shit. And then
like, what? We do a lot of dumb shit that we're really into dumb shit on this podcast.
Yeah, not like dumb shit, just normal high school shit. Like going to parties and trying to mess with girls or whatever.
Shooting
you know,
at parties.
Nah, she's no party.
Sorry, that was a hood nigga.
That was a test. That was a test.
Sounds like us right now. That's what we do every weekend.
You never shot up a party. You just like.
No, I was talking about the going to parties and fucking around with girls.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Somehow I doubt that you guys don't do that. But so you got what? Distracted from
skating? Well, yeah, I just got distracted from skating, yeah. I didn't feel like I was progressing either in high school. And like I graduated and I was just like, man, fuck, I'm about to skate again. You know what I mean?
Right.
And then it kind of just became a trend after that. And then, because skating's been cool, then uncool, then cool, then uncool. It's been like that.
You've seen
forever.
Those cycles? What how old are you?
I'm 27.
27, shit. Yeah. All right, so you fucking seen like a lot more,
nigga,
like the cycles
look
16. Up and down.
What the
yeah
fuck?
Yeah.
I thought it was mad young
yeah
too.
Yeah, yeah.
Black don't crack.
Black don't crack.
Hey, and 27 year olds usually are like over listening to new music by that point. It's like if you're still listening to like interest in new hip hop at 27, you're like an outlier.
Well, you're older than that. You listen to new music.
Yeah, but how
you're
many white guys you know that are 32 and still listen to fucking
like SoundCloud,
like the same shit Ned listens to?
Oh my god.
Ned is a hood A&R, by the way.
We all always got to slander Ned every time on the podcast.
Every time.
But yeah, man. All right, I don't know anything about you guys, but I guess you guys make videos and you guys that's lit. So like, what you guys make skate videos? Like, what's your process like when you go into making a video?
So like, film a bunch of tricks, and then we're like trying to find a song, and we'll just chop the video.
Okay.
Whatever song is like the lit before the song gets like super lit or a super lit ass song. They will play that shit.
Cause like, I'm always listening to new music. Like you said, like listening to new music. Like I used a Lil Yachty song before he got famous.
Famous, right? Yeah.
And he hit me up and he was like, yo bro, like I'm gonna come to LA, like come to my show.
Wow, that's fire.
Like, yeah, that's
fire. Yo, that's gonna be sick.
That. Yachty's crazy, like clued in more than you would think for like the underground shit because
he's young.
So yeah, yeah. And he was like real underground, like up until 6 months ago, 4 months ago. Yeah. You know, like he had the song with Cray and he's like doing shit with all kinds of dudes.
Yeah,
he was like a huge Lil Tracy fan too. Apparently,
I think he still
fucking
is.
Young bro, he's a huge young bro fan.
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah.
So, what do you like? Is it always just the songs that you're listening to, or you hear like songs at random ass places? How you find out about music you want to use in your videos?
I'm just always listening to music. I just use. I don't know if you guys heard of Frisk.
Yeah.
I just use his song, and that shit blew up.
Wait, how do you spell it?
It's a F-R-I-S-T.
How many comments do you get saying song, like question mark?
Song, question mark.
That's the biggest comment ever on anything.
Yeah, that's the biggest comment. Like, song.
You could put the name of the song in the description, too, in the video. It does not matter. It's amazing.
Yeah. People will still hit me up, like, what song is that?
The song, and then right under your comment,
it will be somebody, hey, what song?
What's the song? It's like, I just tagged him and tagged everybody else.
Instagram, it's tough to have a relationship with the kids because they always ask the stupidest fucking shit all the time. It's like, you want to be nice and respond to everything. How do you feel about responding to DMs? You respond to the kids?
I can show you the DMs right now.
Is it retarded? Oh, boy. This will be good. Let's read some DMs. This is like, they do this on DMs. Jimmy Kimmel. You know, like reading like mean YouTube comments. Read nice DMs.
You could just click it.
How many bitches do you have to curve a day in your DMs?
Girls, no, I got a girlfriend, so it's not even true. Like.
Oh, so you're on that.
Drop her at. Drop her at for the world. Too.
Man, I'm seeing people I know in here. Hey, there's me. There's my phone number.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, wait. Look, they got this fool, Yimmy Yayo in the DMs. He's an underground legend, Tumblr legend. I don't know. What did he say to you? I'm going to just read it. I'm just going to violate your privacy real quick. He's trading phone numbers.
He said trade phone numbers.
Damn, I'm just invading your privacy and your life right there. I don't know. Oh, you guys are throwing blunts back and forth? Hey, Hesh, you going to roll up or what?
Oh, yeah.
I know this is going to make it, you retarded so you can't speak. But
no, actually, I was going to ask another question while you were reading DMs. Tell us about the dad movement. Can you first tell us about the clothing line, dad, and then tell us how you like came up with that? Because a lot of kids comment on your shit, dad.
That's pretty
dad.
Much how it started. It was just like kids saying dad, and I was like, man, fuck, I'm about to capitalize on this. I'm going to make shirts, I'm going to make hats, and like really brand it. And then it just worked out better than I thought, honestly. Like,
yeah, it went crazy.
I've been making stuff and just selling out as soon as I put it out, like same day type shit.
How many will you make on average?
On average, like maybe 40-something shirts or whatever. Because I don't even have that much money to like produce that much stuff.
How long have you been doing that for?
Maybe 2 months.
Nice.
Wow, that's sick, bro.
I only had 3 drops so
And you just
far.
Put out whatever you feel like and
well,
just
I've only
always
made,
works?
I made 2 different shirts and 2 different hats and they sell out.
Right.
You got a website also?
Yeah, I got just a big cartel.
Oh, lit. Yeah, that's lit, bro.
That's fire. Do you have like could you see yourself taking it to like a different level, getting more serious with it, or do you think you're gonna
I'd have to have more money to like make like mass produce it.
Wow, somebody Godzilla's out there. What the fuck? Yeah.
to mass produce, but yeah, I do want to like make it bigger.
Right.
Yeah.
So exactly where are you from again?
I grew up in Orange County, and then I moved to LA when I went to ninth grade.
So Orange County, where exactly?
Lakewood.
Lakewood. Yeah. Oh shit. Yeah. All right. So what,
I was looking at your number like 562. I was like, oh shit.
So what, were you hanging out at Howden a lot or what?
No. Not at Howden. I used to go to El Dorado skate park.
Oh, okay, nice. Yeah. But what, you can go to Howden? Why not?
I don't know. I just never.
That's the late night joint. They got the lights and shit.
I was a kid.
You
so
can get
like...
beat up and robbed there.
I know. That's exactly the greatest place for a kid to skate.
A lot of pro. I know pro BMXers who got their bikes took there and then had to get it back through a hood dude. Yeah, it actually.
It's the funnest place on earth.
Hey, Howden's all right, man. You know, Howden's cool.
What about you, Mayo? Where are you from, bro?
I'm from LA, kind of, but I'm also from the East Coast, like Ohio.
Oh, okay, lit. When'd you move to LA?
I moved to LA when I was in seventh grade.
All right, so like last week, then, basically.
Yeah, basically.
How old are you?
I'm 19.
So you're right. He's your protege, or how's that work?
He's your actual son.
My actual son.
Yeah. He's like my
protege. Oh,
what? Turn up.
You gonna flip it on me?
It's OG Joe, man. That nigga's my big homie. He's younger than me.
OG motherfucking Joe, man.
How'd you guys start skating together?
Old as hell. He got mayo on his chain.
I knew somebody named Adrian Elmer from like Deli Size to do with the big hair. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, he knew Cyril, and also there's somebody else named Tony. They both knew Cyril, and we'd just skate together, and we'd go to like this place called Palms. It's a schoolyard. Mm-hmm. So I would make the videos, the slow-mo videos, and like he would be like, yo, like, you know, we gotta go film. So we just started hanging out a lot, and then I just ended up at his house a lot. So
did you ever like imagine you guys being known for the Instagram video style or whatever, or is that just kind of worked its way in gradually?
Just that's worked its way
super in. New.
Yeah. I'm still like, like it trips me out. Like I go to Stoner, like my local skate park, and like there'll be kids from out of town. Like, yo, that's Cyril. Like,
yeah,
I like, take a photo with you. That shit trips me out.
When I first found out about Cyril, like he had like probably 1,500 followers, and I was just like, yo, this nigga's like dope as fuck. And I swear, I transferred from like an Android to an iPhone, and this nigga has like 15K.
And I would have an Android. You are such an Android
kind of
guy.
I was a sidekick Android ass nigga, bro. Don't fucking
with
me.
There's nothing wrong with sidekicks, but why was you an Android ass nigga, bro?
Bro, I was an Android ass nigga.
I don't think
bro.
You can have a sidekick anymore in like 2016.
Bro, I was an Android nigga.
They made it so that they don't even work anymore because Mark Cuban used to have one or some shit.
Really?
Yeah.
I was over that. But,
hey, imagine if you could have edited a video on a sidekick.
I'm trying to get AIM back on the map.
AIM was sick.
Yeah, AIM was hard.
AIM
as
was
well.
Fire.
But wow. Everyone was stealing sidekicks. Like, yeah. We had a sidekick jacket.
You were getting your shit stolen. I had every sidekick. That's the only reason why I had.
You were getting
sidekick.
Your shit stolen.
I ain't
getting
my shit stolen. I was snatching.
I was snatching
shit.
Yo, I got my sidekick took in downtown Manhattan by a fucking Kenyan. Wow. Kenyan. You should have seen this guy run. He was definitely from Kenya, man.
He was going with your shit. I was like a Kenyan.
It happened like, I was like sitting at this table outside this restaurant. There's two girls, and I'm like talking to them. Yeah, and he just walks by, boom, and I just look over. Yeah, and
wait, were you in Manhattan Beach or Manhattan, New York?
Nah, New York City, I was in like Lower East Side.
Just left your sidekick.
I was a bad move, exactly. I should have kept it in my pocket and he still would have got it.
Hell yeah. He would have Spider-Manned it out of your pocket.
He robbed the guy for an iPod Touch.
I thought it was an iPhone.
Oh, Lord.
I hit the lick on him and I get it back to the crib and it was an iPod Touch.
Wow.
You're the worst person
molded.
Ever.
I was molded.
Catching cases.
And I caught a case for that.
You guys ever caught a case?
No. Never.
No?
Yeah,
never?
Yeah, slappers on that motherfucker. Though.
You never even got arrested?
I've never been arrested.
You ever get the cops bothering you while you're skating?
Well, yeah, skating, yeah. Like getting tickets and stuff all the time.
Oh, you guys get tickets a lot? I never get tickets.
Really?
Yeah.
For biking?
Not really. I mean, I don't know. Maybe we're not as ambitious as you guys. What kind of places do you guys get tickets at?
Schools.
They just probably feel bad for you because like you gotta carry that bike over the fence. Like, that's a ticket.
Yeah, man, that's too much.
I feel like the cops never even show up. But maybe if you're going to skate parks like right in LA, it could be more of a pain. Yeah. So I feel like we always leave LA.
And on top of that, like you can't hear the bikes.
Yeah.
Like neighbor, like people complain. And on top of that, what I found out, what a security guard told me,
that's a good point.
The vibrations from the fucking boards send off to the alarm. So that's how the cops are able to come, even if you're out. Like a random ass school.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah. I just found that out.
Scientific shit.
Yep. Yeah.
He did his research.
Yeah, I just.
Audio engineer.
Yeah, no, I just found that out like not too long ago. I was skating Palm Middle School. Everybody really. Real niggas know where Palm at.
Yeah.
Shouts out Kane. You feel me?
That's just really, really wise. Hey, you've never done like a real video part? Is that something you aspire
I have.
To?
Oh, yeah. I watch his video parts. Hey, tell me about Hot Rod and how was that filming and all about SF?
Hot Rod, you mean Smog?
Smog?
Smog.
See, I didn't.
Smog was. Yeah. Smog was. I thought Hot Rod was the full.
No, Smog was the full length video that we came out with.
Oh yeah, no Smog, but your Hot Rod part. You know it's Hot Rod part. I'm talking. Do I have to bring up a Hot Rod part for you?
You mean was it just called? Was it just called Hot?
Yeah, it was called Hot. It wasn't called Hot Rod. Yeah,
it was like all the throwaway clips I didn't use.
Yeah, part. It was the exactly. Yeah. So tell me about that.
That was sick. It was like a bunch of throwaway clips mixed in with like a bunch of like old 90s like girls like in between like that, cut scenes.
And that was 90s girls, Kelly Kapowski and shit.
Yeah, shit like that.
Lisa Turtle? Which one do you pick? Lisa Turtle or Kelly?
I don't know, man.
It's a hard question for any black man. Yeah, I don't know.
They're both fine. But no, that video is sick. Like, not a lot of people even know about the video. Yeah, shouts out to you because that's crazy. Like,
yeah, we were talking about that at Ferg the other day because we were talking about your Smog part too. Shouts out Filmer motherfucking Hands. You feel me? My nigga Zach. Yeah. All them niggas, bro. But tell us about your Smog part.
No, Smog was sick.
That one too then. Smog tell us about sick. That.
We didn't have any kind of connection with like Thrasher or whatever. Mm-hmm. But I was like, fuck, man, we got to get this video on Thrasher. Like, we worked hard on it or whatever. And, like, I just got an email, this guy named, I don't know, his name, like, Mike something. And he literally told me, I emailed him, I was like, yo, your video's sick. Like, we like it, but, like, maybe we'll post it next time around. I'm like, whatever, this is fucking.
He didn't give you, like, a real reason.
He didn't give me a real reason at all. So I was like, whatever, this is whatever. Then I wake up in the morning, and then people were texting me, like, yo, your video part's up. Like, you're the screen cover on Thrasher. Like, I was like, whoa, this is crazy. So they just posted it.
They surprised you?
Even though they said they weren't, yeah. That was pretty sick.
They had like a further debate about the topic.
He probably, I feel like he like made a decision. Then he like showed somebody else. He's like, what the fuck? No, man, post that. Like, he got a second opinion, I feel like.
How big was the effect of like getting that on there?
It was sick, man. A lot of people were hitting me up. Like, even like old pros were like, yo, this is sick. Like, at the skate park, was like, yo, like, I saw your part. Like, that like really got to me. Cause it's
you had like good experiences in that sense with like older dudes who don't, they don't have to reach out, but they actually do.
Yeah, just like, just any kind of blessing from any old head is like super sick in skating, you know?
I feel you. Fucking, so what about like the process of doing Instagram videos versus the process of filming a real video part? Like, how do you differentiate between the
crazy
the two?
Thing about Instagram? No, I don't smoke.
Pussies.
Hey, you want a beer? You want a Tecate?
I'll drink a beer.
All right. So, what's the difference between doing the Instagram video and doing a full length video?
Well, at this point, Instagram is so crazy that
it's a full fucking minute. That's, if you don't know, that's a long ass time.
Instagram is so crazy, and like more people tune in to like me and Joe's videos than like a professional skater.
Right.
Which doesn't make any sense because they're doing hard tricks, but it's just like.
It's a whole package.
It's a whole entertainment.
That shit's fucked up when you think about it. That like young kids seem like they relate to who they relate to, and it doesn't necessarily have that much to do with who's just the best.
Yeah.
Because we know that the best a lot of times is like a 35-year-old fucking weird ass white dude or whatever. That a lot of times the kids like want to see somebody that they can look at, and it like even though you're a little older, like you still look young. It reminds them of themselves a lot more. Fucking, and it's such a weird decision to film for a video part of Instagram now because you know that probably more people are going to see it on Instagram, right?
Exactly. So it's just like I'm gravitating towards doing that more, which is kind of like it's almost backwards in the sense of skating, but it's just like, dude, like I'm going to do this because people are going to watch it regardless. You know what I mean?
It's crazy how the game has changed. Like, in terms of your sponsors, do you think that they would give a shit if you were just like, man, I think I'm just going to do Instagram. I don't really give a fuck about doing
the full part. They're backing it completely.
They love it.
From their perspective, it 100% makes sense because that's like probably way more easier for them to track the effect of, you know?
Yeah.
So was that Thrasher thing, was that your first like industry connect per se?
That was the first like anything I've ever had on Thrasher. Like I've had a clip in a video on Thrasher, but like to have my own part, and I was the first part in the video.
Right.
So it was like a big deal. So like as soon as you click on it, it's just, that's me. Because like some people don't even stick around and watch a whole fucking 11 minute long video.
Right.
So it's just like, that shit was crazy.
That's crazy. But that was the first person that fucked you through it all in the industry in any way?
Yeah, pretty much.
So then like, how did you end up like getting sponsored, or where did you go from there?
I've been sponsored for a minute just by a bunch of random different companies.
Tell us about your friendship. You already know.
Friendship, skateboards, Huff, shoes, Canal Wheels. See, I'm gonna forget somebody and fucking someone's gonna say some shit to me.
Mountain Dew.
Mm-hmm.
Code Red only. But only Code Red. I'm on the Code Red team.
Yeah.
Code Red. You know he's an M1 mixtape player. You know he's
Whoa. Shout out to all my Code Red drinkers.
Code Red is fucking bomb.
Honestly. Or the Activist.
Hey, what's the blue one called?
The Code
what's the blue one called?
I'm trying to get signed
that
to
Baja.
Baja Blast.
Baja Blast. Is that it?
Baja Blast. What's up?
Fucking surfer.
Yeah.
I sent my bitch to the stove because we ran out of soda.
Fuck. Who's mans? Who's ever since we let him at the cookout.
God, I still haven't been to the goddamn cookout.
He's been fucking on the loose.
Me and Iggy Azalea are going to show up arm in arm.
Yo.
Wait, all facts. Me and Iggy Azalea. You don't know who that is? You're so underground that you don't know who she is?
Who?
Yeah. You guys like Iggy Azalea? Would you think you could, might tap, date her if you were single?
Izzy Azalea?
Yeah.
She's huge, right? She's like tall as shit.
She's the white girl from Australia. Yeah, I think she's huge.
She's like 6'3".
She got fake booty or what?
If you didn't know, hey, I remember my first time seeing Iggy Azalea was in the Otis, YG, and Reem Rich's video.
What?
Yes. No. Yes, it's the first time seeing Iggy Azalea.
I want to watch that.
Yeah, watch that. And that's the first time she's ever had any type of appearance in anywhere. Yeah, DJ Mustard and YG brought her out.
You know she played Ham?
Yeah,
back in the day when nobody knew who she was.
Nobody knew who she was, yeah.
House phone, get closer. Like, put your mouth on Hesh's mouth.
Hey, yo. Yo, me and Hesh about to make out for the mic right now.
For the culture.
For Harambe.
For Harambe. The first time I heard Iggy Azalea was just because I heard, like, yo, there's this white girl rapper and she's got ASAP tattooed on her fingers because she's dating Rocky. And I was like, damn, what an idiot. And then I went and looked, and she had it crossed out already.
She's hard. Whoa. She's hard fire. For that, though, for getting his name whacked out. That's like some hood shit.
Not even his name is Crew.
She
said,
fuck that. Yeah, she's like, fuck all them.
Imagine a girl got a No Jumper tattoo. I feel like I own her for life.
I feel like,
what if she get it crossed out, though? What we got to do to her?
Yeah, we got
to
kill her if she get it crossed out.
Like, when she gets an ASAP tattoo over it?
No. If she gets a No Jumper tattoo and then gets it crossed out, we got to kill her.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's like you disrespect my tag.
We
got to
push her down a flight of steps.
Yeah, for sure.
All right.
How do we arrive there?
Just said pregnant.
Pregnant. Oh my god.
Pregnant. Killer.
Killer. You gotta impregnate her.
We talk about killing women a lot. We gotta stop.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, problematic game. 20 years. Adam's not. Hey. Nobody on this podcast is problematic but me.
No. We're all male feminists here.
Yeah. Except me. I'm a regular feminist and a male feminist. I don't know.
A male feminist.
Yeah.
I'm an intersectional feminist.
Yeah.
The fanciest kind.
Hey. He's a Cyril. So, you know, I'm going to ask you about some funny shit real quick. Tell me about Riptide. If you're on YouTube right now, a bunch of kids are going to look this up.
Don't.
Look up Riptide.
I don't even
look
have
up the episode
no
Riptide.
More.
Yeah. There used to be a video. Look. There's a video of Cyril on YouTube. If you look it up. He is just on camera brushing his shit, brushing my shit. No water in my shit, no chemicals in my shit. I know that video because I used it on an Instagram video. That shit is comedy as fuck. Please tell us about it.
It was supposed to be like secret. Like I was doing these secret ass videos. Like,
no, they were private. He only has 5 to 7 views on it.
But it's a wave tutorial?
Yeah, it was a wave tutorial.
Yes,
no,
it
wasn't even a wave tutorial. It was just me flexing my waves.
Literally
like,
flexing his waves. Bro,
it wasn't telling you how to get
there's
it.
There's like 7 videos, and there's one video where he's brushing his waves in the camera, and on the back of this big ass TV, it's him brushing his waves live. And I'm like, yo, what is this?
And then my homie just exposed my whole
shit. Yeah, just exposed his whole shit on Deli.
It doesn't sound like it really exposed it that much of it. 7 views. Or no, it was used in another video?
It was used in another
video. Oh, I know exactly which one you're talking about.
Yeah.
And then after that, bro.
And now Riptide is just like.
Yeah. Yeah. Riptide. No, now it's got to get huger again. He shitted on you. His waves were. Man,
how's
I have no waves. I have no waves. No
yeah, what happened? You decided to switch it
I
up?
I was just like, fuck this, man. I'm not about to be ripped off the rest of my life.
This nigga's like a granddad. This nigga's like a granddad now.
So what, you just cut your shit like bald and you're just like.
I didn't cut it bald. I was just like, it's just hard. Like, I couldn't.
Couldn't keep up.
My hand would hurt, bro. Like, I was like.
The waves is that much work.
Yo, I would catch myself doing it like.
I'm 360.
Like, at work and shit. I was just like, bro, I can't even.
It's the most foreign thing I could ever imagine to me. We've discussed this before, how there's probably like a good market for like wave tutorials and shit on YouTube. How's what I'm saying?
Yeah,
let's see
is,
yours. How's yours doing?
I mean,
I guess he's not very good if he's not taking the hat off.
Shit.
You feel me?
Oh, you woof, bro. You woof.
This should be. Hey, House Phone be dipping. Word the House. Hey, word the House Phone waves, bro. Because that nigga be dipping.
You just made us all look bad. You need to get some mini dreads for the culture because that ain't working for you.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Hey, if you didn't notice, I shaved my whole face.
Yeah,
it's weird.
Yeah, it's really weird. I feel young as fuck, guys.
I couldn't shave my face.
Yeah, I shaved my
face. You showed up with a broken leg and a fucking shaved face, and I'm like, who is this guy? No, for real, for a second, it was like you were just kind of peeking at me from out the car. I'm like, is that him? Do you want to take a quick break to explain how you fucking mauled yourself and also why you're dressed like Cameron?
Also, can you plug the video in while...
okay, for sure. Right, yep. So
watch out, hustle on real quick. Oh, shit.
Hey, can y'all sign my shit real quick? Look at that. Oh, yeah. Okay, we definitely signed in this cast. Let's sign it on air. That's a good idea.
I'm going to draw a big-ass dick on it, so here you go.
They'll probably jerk off to it.
Draw a big-ass dick. Hey, draw a big dick and then put big dicks out for Harambe.
Yes. R.I.P. Harambe. I want to throw that in there, yeah.
I got all the shits, you know, since I broke
my... That's tight that you got it in pink. That's hard.
Markers on.
So you got to wear that pink jacket everywhere you go now.
Yeah, pretty much.
Somebody goes, what's up with that cat? He goes, it's a splint.
It's a splint.
It's a knife.
It's a knife.
So, I don't know, you seen that vibe? Pretty much, I was just like playing. I went to go skate, and I was just skating a bowl, and I was just doing a couple nose grinds, and I was just like, you know what? I just got a new trick. I just did like this alley-oop trick. So did the alley-oop trick or whatever. And I was just like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going to add this nose grind in there. And then I'm going to just keep going to my line.
There's a video of you breaking your leg.
Yeah. So I did it. And then I was like, fuck. I stayed on the ground for like 5 minutes. Got out the bowl. And then I like, he was just like, my brother was like, you want to go to the hospital? And I was just like, nah, fuck that. I'm going home. Like, let's go to your house. So I stayed in Rialto and... As I'm there, like, I'm just screaming the whole night. Like, I literally screamed through the night, like, just the whole night. Like, I had to wake him up in the middle of the night, and I'm just, like, on my face, like, literally on my stomach crawling because I had to take a piss, and I wasn't going to piss on myself. So I waited till the next morning, smoked some weed, went to the fucking hospital. I posted on Twitter, then went to the hospital and shit. And, yeah, I got in there. They told me my shit wasn't broken. It's fucking sprained or whatever. And I got to go back next week to see if I didn't tear a ligament.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Wow.
I'll be skating soon, I hope.
It's not like you need any excuses to be even more immobile.
Yeah.
Because you already spend a lot of time sitting on your ass, I'm going to be honest with you.
I sit on my ass and send emails and skate all day.
What's your impression of him? Because he is just like a dude who's always just kind of around for me. And I just want to know how other people see him.
Yo, for the longest time, I thought PJ's name was CJ. For the longest time, bro. I'm like, who the fuck is PJ? I had no idea.
Yeah, because
people would tell me like, oh, yeah, that's the dude. He's from wherever. I'm like, oh, for sure. You know what I mean?
From what, though?
Not from Riverside.
Right. Yeah.
Because I had a lot of homies in Riverside.
Yeah, I'll be skating in Riverside and they call me Kwani out there. It's pretty funny.
Kwani?
Yeah. It's something that's like a secret name. Nobody knows about that.
Not that secret.
Yeah.
Not that secret anymore.
How is it secret? My real...
Tell the story, yeah.
Oh, my real name is
put your foot down so husband can get closer. Oh, yeah. Nobody wants to look at your ugly ass toes.
You're feeling good, my nigga.
There's like two guys watching this that are like gay dudes with feet fetishes, and they both are so into that part of the podcast.
I was waiting for niggas to sign my shit.
There's one bitch there's one bitch with a foot fetish. Yeah, let me in.
You say you used to fuck with a bitch with a foot fetish?
No, I'm saying there's one bitch with a foot fetish that's watching this getting hard as a rock. Nipples are hard, a clit's hard.
Yeah, but at one point, I moved from LA and I was staying in Riverside. And, while I was staying in Riverside, that's when like Cyril was like booming and skateboarding. And yeah, that's how I heard about him. And then I moved back to LA.
Where's a black marker?
If you don't know where Riverside is, don't go.
Hey, so you stay on Riverside? You ever get tempted to like drink a Monster Energy or like?
Fuck no! I never felt like I never stayed out there that long, and I never like.
Nasty.
Nah. Yeah, it's nasty.
You're on the mic telling how nasty your shit is.
Yeah, my
shit's
nasty.
This nigga's toes are...
My shit's nasty.
Oh, shit.
One of them's painted.
I'm still gonna sign it. I'm still gonna sign your shit.
What are those?
Oh, my
God.
He's
signing the foot.
Yo, why you have, like, bronze toenail polish on? What is your problem?
It's not
even hang out
bronze.
With Ned too much.
It's not even bronze toenail polish. It's this bronze color. Yeah, it's this bronze color.
I thought it was a hard cast. I'm over here like trying to press in and shit.
Yeah, it was hard to get my name on there. Just barely was able to scribble it on there. Yeah, there's a lot of people dying outside tonight. What's up with that?
Okay, now he's trying to flex the waves.
Oh, okay.
I've been done this already, bro. I did it already.
Bro, look up Riptide.
It's over, man. I done it. It's,
I'm coming for you, bro.
I don't even gotta.
I know, but I'm
the new you, bro.
Do you think it'll go away? You're still gonna be just as good at the waves when you're like 40?
I'm not even gonna try to do that shit again, honestly.
Hopefully. Yo, what is happening now?
I'm not worried about waves at 40, man.
Yeah. You think you're better than that?
Yeah, hopefully I'm not worried about waves.
Hey, here's something we haven't talked about yet. Let's talk about fashion, bro. You be snapping out here with the fits.
I was just about to say that before anything, before you saw it done.
Shout out 4 Pins, retweet this.
Yeah.
the fits, that's where it comes back to both of y'all. You feel me? Y'all both be snapping. You know, y'all inspired the jury. You feel me? I gotta go skate with some motherfucking short chains. You feel me?
Short chains.
They put me on the short chains. So if you ever see me, like, this is where I get it from. Like, so explain that. Short chains, the one
short chains.
The uncle, they dress like, they real life dress like my uncle, that, and it's really fly. Like dad hats, the original. You feel me? Like, go ahead.
I've always been into vintage stuff.
Let me turn in a little fetch real quick. Yeah, go ahead.
What
tell them about
on?
The
what's going on outside.
Yeah, it's always some shooters. It's always some shooters outside. You know, dicks out for Harambe. That's how they rock.
That's the way. That's how they dicks on deck. Yo, that's the worst I ever heard it out there.
Yeah, it's really going down right now. Let's get it.
Okay, so. Oh, it's on me now?
Yeah, it's on you. You tell these niggas about that. Tell these niggas, man.
Put the glasses on, but doesn't it get real serious?
It gets real serious. Let me hit the drink.
Wait. Where?
I'm over here watching. Hold up. Wait.
Tell him about the swag.
It's like, what will he roll next?
Yeah, tell him about the swag.
Basically, I've been fucking with vintage shit for, like, my whole life. Like, pretty much. And, like, I just try to incorporate it into my, like, skating. Like, people are like, what the fuck is this dude wearing? You know what I mean? As far as, like, outfits I put together and just shit like that, I guess. Like, I'm trying to think when it really started to, like, I wore a video. There's a video of me wearing all camo.
Straight camo with the glasses.
You know what's so crazy? Like, I know he probably didn't see it or whatever, but as soon as I posted that video, someone tagged Travis Scott. Swear to God, bro. And the very next hour, there was a photo of him in all camo, the exact same fucking camo I had on that video.
What?
That's pretty crazy.
And a skateboard.
Yeah.
And a fucking skateboard. So I'm like, these niggas are secretly watching.
Yeah, no. They really watch. Yeah. No, they watch. They watch.
They're secretly watching, man.
They watch. It's so crazy.
That's I was
so
tripping weird. For like a cool day. I was watch, like, though. Yo, and I was talking to my girlfriend. I was like, yo, there's no way. There's no way that you can see this fucking
That's
video.
Crazy, too, because it's the kind of thing that if you were to, like, blow it out and, like, mention it and shit, people would be looking at you like you're a mad petty. But it's like, you kind of know that it's like, it can't really be a
It's one thing for him to have the full cam on in a photo, but, like, nigga, now you got a skateboard, too. Like, what?
Yeah, that's fucking crazy.
Doing a trick, too. I'm like, and it's a photo, too.
Was
on a video.
Doing a trick, really?
He was. It was a photo of him doing like it looked like a trick.
Like he was like trying to set.
Can we confirm that he can skate?
I'm pretty sure. I fuck with Travis Scott. That fool is dope. Yeah. I don't know if he can skate or not.
Who do you respect as a rapper skater?
No one.
Nobody. No you can't one. Fuck with no Rich the Kid. What about Germ? There's a few.
Compton ass Terry.
That don't count.
I know. I was kidding.
Yeah.
No I fuck one. With Germ. Where's the Germ?
Germ? I don't even know.
Yeah. He hasn't met Germ yet.
Germ's good.
Germ came through Babylon.
Germ's been skating way longer than me rapping too.
Okay. What does he look like?
Germ with tall with jazz.
Tall ass bike dude that's always with Puya.
Yeah.
He's fire though. Jeremy. Check him out. But
He's pretty fire.
He's really good.
He's probably the best skate
rapper.
Yeah.
What about Lil Wayne? No Lil Wayne. You fucking Wheezy on the board?
Oh, of course. I think it's great that he wants to skateboard. I think it's great, but it's just like, I don't know.
The way you did that though, like, yes.
Yeah, I think it's great.
You can accomplish anything if you want to.
Lil Wayne has years under his belt.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
At least three by now. He's gonna be doing some good shit.
I mean, you do see him do stuff that you're like, well, hey, I mean, you definitely have gotten better.
Yeah. He got no steez on it though. Like, he looked ugly on the board. Like, he looked ugly.
That's the problem.
Don't dirt him.
Instantly started skating with just pro ass niggas. Like, why would you want
to
skate with
and them? Renting out a skate park every night to skate and shit.
He has his own skate park, I think.
No, but we're on tour, like, because every skate park I know that was like BMX dudes running or whatever, there'll be some random show where they just end up fucking Lil Wayne ends up skating with them for 6 hours or some shit.
Bro, crazy. And then he references it so much in his music now. Like, he's been skating for like 20 years or something.
Yeah.
A kickflip on your girl. Holly
and
that pussy.
Like. Yo, when did Weezy lose it though?
Shouts out to Weezy.
Shouts out Weezy, man.
Yo, shout out to Mandy with the designer tattoo right there. Number one record. She got the panda tattoo on deck. Panda. Amanda Panda with the designer tat.
All right, I'm transforming back.
You ever use a song in a video and then you regretted it? Like, damn, that dude is whack.
No.
No? Never fucked
you know,
up?
You know, it's the craziest thing about using people's music is just like, I'll go on Instagram and like I'll use a rapper that I think is fucking dope, and I won't look up their Instagram. I'll just like their song and go on SoundCloud, and these people will hit me up like, "Yo, thanks for using my song."
Oh, yeah,
it's like, what the fuck? Then I'll go to their Instagram and I have like way more followers than them.
Yeah,
I don't realize that, you know, like because some people fuck with people's music but don't fuck with them as a person.
How do you discover like new rap music though?
I'm just always on SoundCloud. Like, I be rapping.
Always.
Okay. I be rapping.
Yeah.
So I be listening.
Yeah, me. Hey, Lil Fetch X.
He ain't even gonna
drop Cyril. I'm gonna drop the name Cyril on the Cyril money.
You feel me?
He was not dropping the name.
There you go. If you really fuck with this nigga, now you know Cyril money is out here. Lil Fetch and Cyril money coming soon. You don't even know about it, man.
You guys are gonna collab?
Yeah, definitely.
30 clip with the dick.
Wait, oh,
something just stopped. Shit, right?
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
What were we just talking about? Oh, you guys collaborating.
Oh, yeah. Rap music coming
out. I don't know if I believe it, but.
You do music too?
Yeah, I do music too.
Lil House Phone raps.
Lil House Phone. I've actually heard of your music. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's lit. Thanks.
That's the first time that anyone has ever said that to him.
I'm popping out here.
Yeah, yeah. No, he is. He's coming up in the game, slowly but surely.
Slowly.
That's a tight name.
Lil House Phone got a paid performance Friday. You feel me?
Getting paid.
This is not going to be out by then, but we'll show the recap video. It's about to be fucking lit. You feel me? Dash, Lil House Phone, fucking Ned Arb. I forgot who else. Some other niggas, him and everything. We lit. Let's get it.
Hey.
Let's get it.
Lil Fetch, too.
Lil Fetch.
Oh, man.
Lil Fetch. 30 clip with the dick, rare performance. I might bring him out in a wheelchair.
Clip with the dick.
So let's get it. You ain't down.
That's crazy though, because it seems like you like know about rappers just based on the music.
Yeah.
Whereas like a lot of people, like I feel like I usually know
Hesh in a wheelchair, like in the fucking crowd for a stage dive.
Hey, so you never got into smoking weed?
I used to smoke.
Yeah,
maybe 6 years ago. Yeah, like, yeah. I just couldn't smoke. I couldn't be high and skate, so I'm just like, fuck this. I'm not gonna.
You couldn't combine the two. I feel like he's over here trying valiantly.
I don't know, man.
That's why he broke his leg.
I was about to say his legs broke.
You broke your leg because you're off the kush.
Actually, I was sober.
Point the mic more in the face.
I wasn't smoking actually. Usually when I smoke, I'm cool, but like I was sober because I was in the fucking IE, which is trash. Shout out to the IE.
that might have been
no
the problem.
Weed out there. Their shits are trash, bro.
No weed in the IE?
Weed. Oh, except my nigga Alex, you feel me?
Chili Sosa would be offended by
you. Oh, no. Yeah, Chili Sosa, all them niggas. Chili Tuck, all them niggas. But no, on the side I was in, like Rialto is trash, bro. The skate park I was at is dope.
Yo, shout out to Rialto. I'll fuck with y'all, man.
Yeah, Rialto is tight.
I fuck with y'all.
That shit slandering y'all game right now.
Rialto is tight. Hey, y'all Rialto is tight. Real life.
Rialto gang.
Yeah, Rialto gang. It's
Rialto gang.
Hey, I got noticed from out in Rialto. That was pretty cool from somebody that said no jumper. Shout outs to you in Rialto. Shout outs to Rialto, man. I fuck with all my niggas. Tyson, all
Explain
my niggas.
Explain what the fuck you're talking about. What the fuck is Rialto?
Rialto is like in the IE where I broke my that skate park.
Oh, okay.
The
IE, though, you got to let them know.
IE is like the... It's like the land. It like when you come to California, if you ever hear like on Lion King where they be like... The land you do not touch. That's where you don't go because there's nothing out. It's like
it's
literally
boring,
the desert.
Yeah it's
the desert.
You go to Riverside and it's just like crackhead.
But it's like good. Like the reason why I go out there though, because it's like a real, like all my niggas real life be out there skating and shit. Like they really be on some skate shit.
Well, Riverside's good for skating.
Yeah, they do a lot of spots out there.
There's a lot of spots out there.
Downtown Riverside, too.
Yeah, downtown, all there.
That's like true, too. But it's like, cool. Hey, so how do you feel about skating street versus skating skate parks? I feel like most of your videos, you're focused on the plazas and shit.
Just because the plaza is like a controlled environment.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like in the streets, like you don't know if you're going to get kicked out.
Right.
You don't know if like a fucking, there's going to be a car parked at a spot that you need to fucking hit. So it's just like, it's controlled and you can get more creative.
But is that how you feel as like a skater, that you're that type of skater who likes to just go and just focus and just like skate for a long ass time and not have to be bothered by security skating around and shit?
No, it just depends. Like, because there's a whole point of my life where I didn't even go to the skate park. When I was filming for that part, I didn't go to the skate park at all. I had to like, all right, let me focus on getting these clips and making this shit happen. So I didn't even go to the skate park at all. So it just all depends, you know?
Yeah. What about having a girlfriend? Were you a savage before her?
No. No, I wasn't. I wasn't. I was not a savage.
Look at Joe.
Wasn't a savage. No, man.
Not a true savage.
Not a true savage.
You like 21 Savage?
21 Savage?
Yeah.
The rapper. 21. Yeah. 21.
Of course.
21. Yeah. 21.
Oh, okay. Good. How could you not? Yeah.
He's fucking sick.
So, what's your average day? Like, you just wake up, roll out of bed, and just go skate?
Mostly, dude. Like, honestly, I've been blessed to, like, make these clothes, and this shit's been paying my rent now.
Really?
Wow. So, I could work less. I only work 2 days a week now.
What do you work doing?
I work at a grocery store.
Oh, nice.
In Brentwood. So, it's cool, but.
That's lit.
Mm-hmm. It's cool, but that's not where I want to do.
You are fucking in a relationship, working at a grocery store in Brentwood,
bro, and popping on the internet.
You get so many fucking random white milfs there, bro. Crazy. They can get you a sugar mama right now that pay for you and your girlfriend.
Just throw your Instagram on the shirt. Like, no.
No. Hey, follow
me.
Do you wear gold tooth and jewelry at work?
No, I
you
can't.
Should. That would be tight.
They won't let you? That's fucked up.
Yo, when I come into work to get my check sometimes, people are like, what the fucking shit is going on?
Who's this gangbanger?
About to be bestowed upon them.
But he wore Yeezys to work one day.
Really?
Yeah, he did wear Yeezys.
And they were cool with that?
But they're all. I got to wear all black shoes. Yeah. And then like some people, like a couple of coworkers, like, what the fuck? You got Yeezys on, nigga? Like, what are you doing in here with that? Like,
yo, I remember when I worked at Sears selling shoes that I would constantly, I was like 16 and you had to wear like black like dress shoes and they hurt my fucking feet so bad. I was always just wear Vans or fucking Edneys or some shit and I'd stay getting in trouble for that. Because you could kind of pull it off until somebody actually took a good look at you.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true.
The Edneys.
You ever had a job? I could never see either of you having jobs. I know you worked at Pacific somewhere.
Don't ever call it that ever again.
Pac Sun, sorry. Oh, yeah, I forgot that they changed it like 10 years ago.
Fuck both of those places.
Get your mouth in there. Pause.
Fuck both of those places. That shit, yeah, that's what she said. Yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking, that place sucked. Fuck that place. I worked at Jamba Juice for like 2 years.
Whoa.
Also worked at like a children's charity. I worked at a whole bunch of places, bro. Fuck having a job. Now yeah, I just sell drugs and I rap.
There you go.
And none of them are paying
my bills.
See,
I'm trying to get like a little house phone, honestly. I'm trying to sell drugs and rap.
But honestly, no, that shit doesn't pay any bills. I'm like trying to get a regular job right now. Let me hit that too, little fetch.
No, did you ever do like, you ever get in like serious trouble as a kid? You never got arrested, but were you ever doing any like fucked up shit?
I got caught stealing when I was really young. And
stealing
my mom,
what?
Stealing like, I think a tech deck.
Oh, man. Born to be a skater, boy. Wow.
Or maybe a tech bike. Hey, tech bikes were cool, too.
Ooh, those are cool.
You put in there and spin around and
thank
shit.
Thank you for the culture, yeah.
Hey, shout out to any kid I sold those to because I was flipping them.
Yo, but the finger bike.
The finger bike was sick.
The finger bike, though, it's funny when you think about it because it really, like, it summarizes why, like, skateboarding is more popular than BMX because the finger bike is all, like, falling apart as soon as you get it. It's like a million moving pieces and the tech deck is just, like, so simple and, like, yo, you see those dudes on YouTube who are, like, crazy professional with the fingerboard?
Shout out to my nigga Drake, man. Eminent, man. My nigga Rakes Full. My nigga makes full fucking...
Yeah,
I seen a guy with like
yeah, he makes.
I seen a guy with a popping YouTube channel full of videos of him doing the most complicated routines. It's just the craziest shit ever, man.
It's probably him.
It's probably him or his crew.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
it's fucked.
The homie, yeah, and they sell for like $120 or
something. You guys ever still? You guys ever do that shit?
Yeah, the fingerboards are expensive.
Yeah, well, they use like real like metal and like wood.
Filmer hands uses them,
and they have like plies and shit.
I already know. Those are like expensive.
Yeah.
There's a fingerboarder that follows us. And he's super famous though. He's famous on Instagram.
Drake
fingerboarding. That's his name?
Yeah, Drake.
Oh yeah, I didn't know who that was. I don't think I followed him back because I was like a fingerboarder.
Yeah,
like,
me, Nighthawk, all the niggas, we know him.
I got him right now.
Yeah. He works for Tech Deck now.
He does? That's cool.
Who's the most famous person that follows you?
That follows me? Fuck, man. Lil Yachty.
Me?
Oh, that's a good one. Me too, probably. Yeah. Good point. I asked this dude, RRD Blocks. He's like this mountain bike dude who does these really long wheelies, and he's got like 200K. I asked him that, and his answer was Usain Bolt.
What the hell is that?
Whoa, he got that Usain?
Like,
whoa, that's the fastest man in the world.
Whoa! That nigga's fast!
I could not believe
it. My leg is broke that make me want to run.
Whoa! He's like the fastest man in the world or
some
shit.
That's crazy.
Yeah. I know. I was like, man, that's so cool that he has like appreciation.
Hey,
he does like wheelies. He lives in New York and he does wheelies on like a big mountain bike type thing.
Oh, I know you're talking about. Hey, doesn't the mountain, like the front tire come off?
And he does the shit where he'll like swerve in front of a bus and move at the last possible second and shit.
Oh, I have seen that. He's just swerving and like, I know you're talking about. I know you're talking about.
The tire comes off the wheelie and he comes.
He keeps going down. Yeah,
he goes viral like every week. Fucking off that shit is crazy.
Whoa. Just wheelie the whole time.
That's what people are interested in on the explore page.
It's definitely something kind of relatable, you know.
Yep.
So tell us about your photography.
Oh, what people don't know about the LYD shit, I take all the photos for it too.
Oh, really?
So like all the photos and like creative directing it, like I do all that shit myself. I don't want any, like I want people to like, he modeled it, but I made sure like I don't want any faces. I don't want to have any kind of like identity yet, you know what I mean?
Right.
Until I'm like really, it's like, all right, I want this person to be wearing my shit, you know what I mean? So I don't want to have any kind of identity. So all my photos are chopped at the face and like really focused on the clothes.
So how did you get into taking photos in the first place though?
I went to school for photography for a while.
Okay.
And so I was gonna like actually get a certificate and like get certified to be like a photographer. I was just like, man, fuck this. Like, I'm not trying to like, what I was doing was like news photography pretty much.
Right.
And I wanted to go more into like,
art.
Art, fashion, but pretty much.
News photography, too.
Yeah. So, like, so I learned what I need to learn.
Probably the worst job prospects ever, too, right?
Yeah.
I don't know if you want me to talk about this, but your zine, you know.
Oh, I did do a zine for Babylon.
You feel me? You did a zine.
But did you ever think about getting, like, real serious, like, photographer with the skate shit?
No, I hate skate photography.
Really? What about it?
It's just, it takes a long time, yes. and people criticize it so much because there's so many different angles you can get it with every trick.
Right.
Like, with the, like you taking a picture of a t-shirt, like, oh, that's a fucking tight t-shirt. Like, no one's going to, like...
And there's so many people who are so sick, too. Like, yeah. Real creative, and it's, like, real competitive, and it's so crazy when you think about it, too, the dudes drag around, like, $10,000 worth of equipment to take a photo and get paid $150 or whatever. Yeah. It's, like, not... The money doesn't really, like, make that much sense.
It, but
like,
those dudes love it, dude.
Yeah, they're so crazy.
It. See, I don't love skate photography. Like,
right, yeah. You gotta really like it's gotta be a crazy ass labor of love for you to be doing that shit. It's crazy.
Hey, Michael Mealy, I saw OG too. I saw my nigga Michael Mealy
because we interviewed Jacob Messix.
Oh, yeah,
that was fire.
I used to be
his photos were dope.
Yeah, he's a hella young too, super successful. That was really cool. That was real early on. What were we just talking about? Oh, the photography shit.
Yeah. what were we just talking about?
Hesh is over there getting me high as fuck.
You feel me?
I don't fuck with you.
Literally, as the sentence just finished, he's like, wait, hold on.
Hold on, what?
I keep getting distracted and shit. You guys got me on this backward lifestyle over here. I've never smoked weed before.
I never smoked weed before.
And you got, with the broke
why are you guys writing the N-word on the fucking table? What is going on here?
Man, that's my name, Hesh nigga.
Oh, right. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, man. This thing, we ever smoking Harambe dicks, man. We smoking Harambe.
Wait, hold up. Pause. Smoking dicks, guns, bro?
Now you're smoking dicks.
I don't know about this nigga. I didn't roll them too big just so he couldn't say that. I didn't roll them too big.
That's not even close to the most problematic thing the house phone has said to me, like, of late.
Okay.
Oh, my
gosh.
Guns. Hey, what are your favorite...
What's going on?
Your favorite examples of, like, slang in the culture right now? Like, things that you think are funny. Okay, I was not asking you because I know what you're gonna say.
Damn, I don't know. What do you think, Joe?
Low key, high key.
But I want to go to the mall.
On the real, me and this nigga will see each other at a party and be like, low key.
Also, like, everybody's a blood now.
Yeah. Everybody's a blood. So everybody's whooping
up. You got to add some bees in there, no matter what.
Cripping, I don't know.
Yeah, shout out to my nigga's cripping. You feel me? Wow, it's really deep. You feel me?
Shouts out, but Spody. I feel like it's funny to
shouts out Spody.
It's fun to switch the C in too. Like, you could do the B and the C, shit. But you might not want to do it. I don't want to do it because I don't want anybody to get the wrong idea.
Yeah.
I don't want anybody.
You know that R. Kelly is like 45 and he has a 19-year-old girlfriend now? You see that?
Flexing.
19.
She's fine. Not low-key, nigga. You better give it to her.
19?
She better be fire. I didn't see her.
She's dumb.
I feel like I'm 32 and it's already so hard for me to relate to a 19-year-old chick that I cannot even begin to imagine what it's like for him. He must be real weird.
Damn.
Oh, the Drake's dad song. Dennis Graham. Yeah, I forgot about that. Shout out to my brother Noah, man. Dennis Graham. What song? We just found out Drake's dad is coming out with an R&B album and
really?
We listened to his song.
Drake's
dad. Oh, shit. I'm like, Drake's dad.
Whoa, Drake's dad has like hundreds of thousands of followers and he's like always that. At like tell, every tell like what, listening what, event and party and shit. Like he's out here.
Yo, this morning me and my nigga Hesh, you feel me?
Get right in there.
Just fucking around. And
before I went to the hospital, before I even got up to get to the hospital, I said, hold on, wait. Play this shit.
Bro, Dennis Graham, Aubrey Graham, aka Drake's dad. Got them hitters.
Got them hitters.
Hitters.
Got them hitters.
Drake's ghostwriter going in right now.
I know,
right?
R&B for the
whole
family.
R&B is.
I don't think Drake like necessarily supports his dad's career. You think? He does?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. He's on OVO.
He got an OVO chain.
Okay.
OVO chain.
Well, then I fucks with him. Then that's legit. Then. Wow,
I think
that's crazy.
Drake said something about his dad coming out with music in mute, like in one of his songs.
It's pretty far.
That is really cool. Like, I did not know that. That's
good for Drake.
You learn something new every day.
Now we're just discussing like random hip hop facts.
I know.
Wait, would you use a Dennis Graham song?
I don't know, man.
You gonna use that tonight?
I'm about to use a little Fetch song.
Oh, shit. Hey, let me ask you this. You ever have problems with them taking your songs down?
Never.
No, it hasn't happened because you go mad underground.
I go mad underground, and I haven't. Yeah, you're right. I haven't since they made that update. I haven't used anybody.
On top
like that.
Of that, remember when you were chopping and screwing songs?
Yeah.
We were chopping and screwing songs on videos. That was pretty.
That's him. He does that.
I was like, wait, you were doing that?
No, that's him.
That's why I said you guys. That's why I said you guys. No, that's why I said you guys.
You just start chopping everything.
Yeah, no, like.
But see, the thing is with Joe, like he had the slow mo thing going.
Yeah,
like,
he
this
started.
Is tight.
He intros slow mo. And then slow-mo. It's pretty.
And then his shit changed kind of more until like now we kind of make the more similar videos.
Yeah, it was like we blended together.
Yeah,
like,
pretty much.
I left and he just started blowing up.
Yeah, pretty much. He went to San Jose. Like I don't know. I think I had like 5,000 followers when he went to San Jose. Yeah. And he came back like he was gone for the summer, and I had like 15.
Yeah,
came back.
That's pretty wild.
Because that video, crazy. I know you saw. That's the one that you guys reposted on No Jumper, the one I used Larry June.
Yeah, yeah.
Had 150 something thousand views.
That's crazy.
Which is crazy because it's like at that time I only had like 20,000 followers.
That means it's going like mad viral. There's so many people are watching.
And it didn't get reposted. Like you guys reposted it. I posted it, and I think that's it.
Yeah.
So I feel like people don't know about this in skating. I'm gonna give everybody a little secret if they're watching and paying attention to make these videos.
Don't give out the secrets. Don't give out the secrets.
I need to know.
You need to know.
Is it gonna be about the time?
Still in the edits.
No, they're already still in the edits. B.
They're gonna give out the secrets.
Cover photos.
Yo, cover photos. Is
cover
the mad,
photos.
Now, I will give them now.
Because yours are always you cover flying through the air and shit.
It's the
I'm not even gonna say because it's just people.
Or a girl.
I'm about to do that. What?
Or a girl.
Or a fall.
Yeah, it's always the fall.
Yeah, it's always a fall. So it's just like. But like this, like someone that doesn't skate, right? And they see somebody falling, right. Like I want to see this motherfucker fall.
Yeah.
And then they end up watching, and like, oh, this is a fucking tight video.
It's the most
and that
like, person, relatable
like,
thing.
There's a lot of people like that video has like a bunch of comments on it or whatever, and it's a lot of different girls,
right?
That don't have anything to do with skating, tagging their friends. Like, what the fuck is going on? Like, if I go through those comments and just look, it's just like none of these people skateboard.
Have you ever thought about doing YouTube, like doing like behind the scenes, like vlog type shit or whatever? Because
I have thought of like my cousin was trying to like, yo, you should like make videos and put them on YouTube to try to make money. But like that goes into like, I can't film myself, you know, I would need him. He's going back to school. And it's just like, that's like a whole nother.
Yeah. Because there are like more and more dudes who are like kind of making it skateboarding and doing shit on YouTube.
A lot of those dudes
are kind of corny.
Yeah. A lot of those dudes are corny.
Yeah.
But
no, there's a lot of like kind of
corny ass dudes. Yeah.
But I kind of like appreciate all of them for what they're doing, even though it's awesome. But that's the thing is like somebody, if they came out and just did like a super like legit version of it, like really hanging out with like cool ass people and all that shit, you know, I feel like it would be kind of fresh.
Would be cool.
It's possible. It's got to be possible.
Are you rolling up again?
He's a fiend, dog. And now he's rolling a joint. Now he's switching
shout
his whole swag
son.
Up.
Hey, shout out
yo, pay this man. He just shouted out everybody he knew.
That's how he begins every sentence. Hey, yo, shout out to Kate. Shout out
hey,
beer.
Yo, hey, shout out. Shout out.
Trader Joe's beers, you feel me?
Hey, shout out. Shouting out. I'm shouting out everybody. Shout out to my shout outs right here.
Shout out to designer.
Hey, dead ass though. Shout out to my son for these, though.
Cause I have a bunch of them. I'm not even old enough to buy these motherfuckers.
Wait, yo,
how old are you?
300.
Yo, but they just changed the tobacco laws for people buying it. But then they also changed the laws about tobacco companies doing like promotional stuff. Like I heard that if you like, they have to handle it differently now. If you're a person such as myself who deals with tobacco brands, you have to like. I don't know. Some things have changed.
You have to be 21 and buy cigarettes now.
Yeah, but then also it's like weird shit with people who get like hooked up with blunts. Like I don't know if they're like technically allowed to like give people blunts.
Oh, because they're younger. Okay,
it's just
sense.
some different shit than now about promotional shit.
They send them from out of state.
I don't know exactly how it's gonna work.
It's only California.
Yeah, it's only California.
I don't know.
So but anywhere else you can still be 18 and buy it.
Yeah.
Like buy tobacco.
Yeah.
It's only California.
Apparently.
It's only California.
Shout out to my niggas in Cali under 21 still smoking them blunts, man. It's not blunts, backwoods.
Everybody hyped up backwoods way too much.
Yeah, too much.
They're like, all right, we got to stop.
Like, it's like Four Loko. Yeah. We got to take the shit off the market.
Yeah.
People are dying.
You ever have some Four Loko nights?
I've had a Four Loko night.
Oh,
before they took out the caffeine, so I was
That was when it was just.
That's when it was lit.
Yeah, that's when people were like dying, right?
Yeah, all the time. I almost died.
Bro, you might not wake up.
Yeah,
yeah, those shits were gnarly.
Dude, the Four Loko with the fucking blow, you might not wake up, bro.
I don't know about all that.
That's scary shit right there.
Man, niggas was
I had
on
those
MySpace.
Nights.
It was MySpace, so you know you had a Four Loko with a blunt in your hand.
It was probably still kind of MySpace at that time, yeah. Maybe like the early days of Twitter. I don't know.
Yeah, I feel that. This nigga said MySpace. I'm like, you take it back a little far. I don't think niggas is drinking Four Loko.
Yo, but it's crazy when like they act like it's so hard to like ban guns or like change gun laws, but they got rid of Four Loko with the caffeine in like 2 weeks. Like it happened like overnight. I saw somebody tweet about that, and I was like, man, that's so true.
That is crazy. They did ban it really fast.
Yeah. I had a night where I don't even know. I puked up a lot of salmon.
It's okay. You don't got to say it. You don't got to say a story.
It's
all
right.
Man, that nigga, yeah, he got real deep on that one.
Any topics we should finish before we wrap this up?
Well, I'm glad you let me do this interview, man. Honestly, like, the main thing I wanted to, like, get out there is just, like, I'm going to start making music. And that was, like, the whole point of, like, making these videos and using these underground rappers and, like, getting that style out.
It makes a lot of sense.
So I'm going to start making music. And I'm, like, already, like, collabing with certain artists and going to put out a couple songs.
Really?
And do that.
That's
yeah.
dope.
Yeah.
Let me know. We can
Let's
promote
get
that.
Cyril.
Yeah, you guys have a posse track.
Hey, honestly, I was going to bring him out for one of his first performances. I shouldn't have.
But he had the weirdest time. It was from six to eight.
It was a weird ass
like,
performance.
Who's about to show up from six to eight?
Yeah, it was like a crazy ass little in-house performance. It was pretty crazy.
Should come do it during our set at the Chris Travis show at the end of the month.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
It's gonna be
one really song. We'll promote it so everybody will know the song. Yeah. That'd be fire.
Shout out to all the Rope Gang. You feel me?
Yeah. Shout out Rope Gang. Everybody's gonna come and sing the song. Everybody, the song we never heard, but we're assuming that we're gonna really like it.
It's so crazy.
With the dick.
I always expecting that song to have the most plays, but the song that has the most plays is Hell No. Rope Gang. It's Hell No, Rope Gang. Yeah, it's
I gotta crazy. Listen to this shit.
Yeah. Produced by Ned.
I've only heard one of your songs, and that's the catchy one. The one that you posted on Instagram. Yeah, I'm like, hold up, this is kind of.
Hell No is a slapper too. He shout out to me on that song. Shout out to the Rope Gang. You feel me? So I fucks with that song.
That's crazy.
That is crazy.
SoundCloud.com/LilFetch, my nigga.
Wow.
Whoa.
SoundCloud.com/LilHouseMall. I just dropped my EP, my nigga.
Oh, yeah. What's good, house EP, my nigga? Man. Everybody shouts out say songs if it shit. Shouts out
Lil Mayo.
Shouts out C-Roy.
Wait,
Lil Mayo got to drop a track. You feel me?
I'm about to record this song right now. Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Look out for that Joe X Mayo. You feel me?
Looking for that Joe Button.
That Joe Button.
Joe Button X House Phone dropping soon.
Joe X Bands. Oh, so that's got the two Z's and a dollar sign, huh?
Something like that.
Joe Bands.
Don't worry. I'll put all the URLs on the screen. Don't worry.
Put all the URLs on the screen. Yeah, I've actually used one of my songs in the video, and people are like, now like kids are hitting me up about songs. Like, yo, like I even posted a photo like, yo, I need beats, and like now my DMs went crazy.
Crazy.
You know what I mean? So it's just now people are like looking forward to me making music. That was like the whole like I was like Lil Yachty said in an interview. He's like he got his face out there
right. A
lot before he even promoted his music.
Right.
And that's pretty much what I'm doing, but like in a whole different way.
But it's like Yams like built up that Tumblr presence on his Tumblr and then like brought out Rocky, and like he already had like so many eyes on him that when he brought out an artist, he had like such an ability to get him out there. Yeah. You know?
So it's almost like
covert operation.
Yeah, I didn't think like people were telling me like you should do this, but I didn't think about it, you know what I mean? I didn't know how many people were watching me and like looking and paying attention to what I'm doing.
Right.
So of course I'm gonna put out music, people are like, all right, I gotta check this dude out. And if it's good music, people are like, oh, I'm rocking with this, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that only makes sense.
Well, hey, that's dope. We gotta get some follow this motherfucker on SoundCloud. The link is in the description, bitches.
C-Roy Money on SoundCloud.
Check it out.
Only shout out I'm giving right now.
Hey.
Only one.
Hey, thank you very much to House Phone, Hesh, Mayo. Hey,
thank y'all for coming.
Rope Gang. Mandy with the designer tat. I hope the sound worked, even though it seems like it kind of got weird with the headphones for a minute there. It seems like it was recording okay. All right. Thank you very much.
Squad.
Peace.
Hey, what's up? Hey.
Real Rope Gang, screenshot
this.
Are you controlling from your computer?
Nah.
Oh, well. I saw you like, click something and you look at the camera. Like, oh, shit.
Designer tag.
Some kids
are going to
screenshot.
Oh,
that is.
I don't think
Monte, tell them that I got the designer tag before the designer got the song.
You should be proud that you predicted the design.